parking spots.
Lousy butt kissers coming in before noon, eating donuts that are rightfully mine.
Oh!
Stupid smart car! Spot hogging SUV! Inconvenient sinkhole! Mandatory credit! Developed by? What does that even mean? It's empty!
Oh no, that's Burns' spot!
How could you miss that sign?
The last guy that parked there is now a speed bump.
Slow down!
Guys, be cool! Burns will never know. He's on vacation this week with his weirdo hunting buddies.
Fellow members of the Order of the Knights of St. Caucasian, we've got a lot of things to kill today, so release the sedated quail. How am I supposed to hunt it if it can move?
Try it now, Davy Crockett!
Damn, you surface tension!
Wait a minute. If I can park in Mr. Burns' space, I can live his whole life! Quickly now, before I think it through!
The big stuff. Who do you think you are? Mr. Big Stuff. You're never gonna get my love.
Along and sing a tiki song.
And everyone will take their turns
to celebrate a man who's great, the Wiki Waka Leaky Laka Magic Mr. Burns.
The Wiki Waka Leaky Laka Mr. Burns. The Wiki Waka Leaky Laka Mr. Burns. The Wiki Waka Leaky Laka Mr. Burns. The Wiki Waka Leaky Laka Mr. Burns. The Wiki Waka.
Simpson lines up his hitty stick and gets ready to clobber the dimpled roundo. He's calling the signals.
Omaha! 35! Hut! Hut!
Simpson!
Incoming! There's a light bulb out on level P2!
Oh, good lord. The trapdoor's under renovation. It's not safe.
No! No! Mosaic!
Congratulations, you're halfway down.
What the? Oh, I'm drowning in cement!
It's actually concrete.
Woohoo!
Of which cement is an ingredient?
Marge, you thought of everything, except for one nagging detail.
Did I ever tell you about the time I was in a big cast? It was the Shelbyville Players production of Pippin.
Don't worry, homie.
I'm a player to ticket taker in one performance. There's two ways.
You are in my seat!
Fight! Fight! Fight!
Asthma! Glasses! Asthma!
Oh, there's too much violence in rearview mirrors these days.
Hey, boy. Want to sign your old man's cast?
No problemo.
What does it say?
Don't worry about it.
What did you write?
Sorry, that's between me and everyone who sees it.
I need to know!
Begins with F and ends in CK.
Well, you little... Get... Move me! Tell me!
Never!
Oh!
Thanks, partner. We've balled up all the 13-gauge alpaca.
Now maybe there's something fun we can do?
Sure is. A puzzle. Foggy day in Berlin. 5,000 pieces.
Homer, complete the puzzle.
I'm a married man.
Fine. If you need me, I'll be in your Spankenbank.
We'll meet again.
Marge, I don't think we should do this puzzle.
I know. You can't pick up the pieces. That's why I've devised a grid system. Huh? I'll hold up a piece, and you call out the number and letter of the corresponding grid square.
I don't know. Q15?
Sweetie, it's a side piece. Q15's in the middle.
Right, Q15 is in the middle. Nothing more fun than rules.
I'll make some tea to help you think.
Oh, I hate being immobile and numb. If only I was free to move. Oh, if only.
It's never pleasant to see this kind of activity, Lisa. Particularly on a cell phone that is so much nicer than the one I own.
All the fighting seems to start with who sits where on the bus.
Lisa, you seem to have a handle on the bus problem. Why don't you tackle it? But don't think I won't help. I'm providing you with a sash.
Skinner, you are asking a 6-year-old girl to fix this school's problems.
I'm 8.
Oh, carry on.
What do you mean there's a legal issue with my trap door? As you explained, please take 2 steps back.
The old trapdoor was perfectly legal. It was grandfathered in under the Reagan-era code. But once you start renovating it, it has to be brought up to modern standards.
And it has to be handicap accessible. A wheelchair would never fall through the current opening.
Oh, but that's not a problem. I refuse to hire the handicapped.
That's another issue. But for now, we have left ourselves open to a lawsuit by Homer Simpson.
Fine. Smithers, go see this Simpson character and trick him into signing a waiver of liability. I'll discuss things with the foreman. Enrique Mascrani La Puerta!
Look, homie, we got 3 pieces together. That's a good day's work.
Why don't we do one of Maggie's puzzles? Kyle goes in the cow-shaped hole, boom, next case.
I thought the one good thing about you hurting yourself was that we could spend more time together.
You did?
Didn't you?
Oh, yeah, sure, of course. Only a fool would admit otherwise.
Mr. Smithers, come in, come in.
Oh, well, there's our Tanglefoot already on the mend.
Yeah, right. They say it'll be 3 months before I can scratch my ass. 6 before I can really go at it.
Listen, I don't want to take up your time. I just need Homer's signature on a couple of things. First, a get-well card to himself.
And what else does he need to sign?
Oh, a waiver of liability. I know. There are solid reasons to sue, but do you really want to fill your life with parasitic attorneys with get-rich-quick schemes?
Schemes? Rich? Quick? Parasitic? Woohoo! How could I have forgotten to sue Mr. Burns? That's how you get rich in America! Sue USA! Sue USA!
Oh, Lord.
Finally, a chance to use this! Was designed ironically, but I would die for it.
Are you home during the day because you were injured at work, school, museum, church, Iraq? Elevator plummet, uneven sidewalk, hit by foul ball, hit by fair ball, or Iditarod viewing party?
The first one you said!
Call me, Maxwell Flinch, at 555-555-5555.
555. Wait, what was the number after the first 3 fives but before the last 6 fives?
Simpson, before you do anything rash, Mr. Burns wanted you to enjoy this get-well cake.
What's that writing on top?
Oh, it's just a strawberry boilerplate absolving us of liability. Now just bite here, 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 nibble here, lick here. Your wife needs to eat this cupcake.
Sir, you cannot bribe me with cake, because I just ate several pies.
Hello, Mr. Smithers. I see you haven't given up.
Just enjoy the cake. As long as you don't eat it in front of a notary public, you're fine.
I'm a notary public. You gave your ink pad to Maggie. Oh.
I'll walk out with you.
Don't go yet. You guys can help me brainstorm a pattern for my new quilt.
Marge, I mean this in the nicest way. Your idea of fun makes me want to blow my brains out.
Oh, razzmatazz is perfect, Marge. It's red, but not too red.
You're right. Why don't you stick around and we'll discuss stitching patterns over tea?
I'd like that.
And I'll take the cake back to the home and share it with the seniors.
Typical.
I'll keep Dad company.
Thank you, Bart.
Oh, I dropped it.
What did you put down my back?
Could be a tarantula. Could just be some yarn. I'll be at Millhouse's.
Oh! What the hell?
Oh, it's such a pleasure to pour tea for someone and not have to help him chew it.
We've made our choices, and the world doesn't understand them, but we do.
You know, Marge, somehow I feel that more than anyone you understand those horrible words. What do you see in him?
I never said this. But did you ever think we cling to these guys because we're afraid to admit we were wrong?
Do you really think that?
Well, I've tried to use it constructively.
I try to have the serenity to accept the things I cannot change and the courage to change the things I can.
That's what they said to me at that Alcoholics Unanimous meeting.
Attention bus riders, my new seating plan avoids conflict through the use of complex social algorithms. It teams up compatible seatmates and places Millhouse with no one.
Yet somehow I'm still a little scared.
Otto, why are you sitting in back?
Waiting for my assignment, Chief.
The driver's seat. You're the driver.
Still me? New management, same mistakes. It's so quiet. I've never been able to hear my music before. It sucks.
This is just the beginning. Soon I'll have control over every aspect of their lives, and then I'll make them achieve their undreamt dreams. Sherry next to Terry. Jimbo next to Dolph. No one next to Millhouse. Ralph next to his invisible friend. Kearney next to Nelson. Martin next to Wendell. Cosi next to Database. My first PG-13 fantasy!
Since we haven't been able to get a settlement, we'll have to start preparing you for your deposition. Carolyn here will stand in for the opposing attorney.
Good afternoon, Mr. Burns.
Release the hounds.
Sir, you should try to project a friendlier demeanor.
Release the hounds. Please!
Seriously, sir, it would really be wise not to mention the hounds.
Oh, that's like telling Three-Finger Brown he can't play for the Brooklyn Tip-Tops.
Well, now I can see why so many women in movies have gay friends, like Princess Leia and C-3PO. Listen, I made this for you.
Oh, my God. No one ever gives me a gift. Thank you.
No one ever tells me thank you. I think you see my true self, the one I never pay attention to at all. Oh, my God. I want to kiss him.
Oh, my God. She wants to kiss me.
I'm a married woman.
She would look good with a mustache. I've got to go.
Thank God I've got a husband with benefits. Come here, you.
Okay, but what? Hey, what?
Smithers.
Wait a sec. Marge is getting her emotional needs fulfilled by another man, and now she needs me for nothing but sex. I'm the luckiest husband in the world!
You haven't gotten that stupid signature yet?
No, and I'm not sure I want to.
You defy me? Smithers, pour me a glass of water. Now, squeeze my chest. Now, either get that signature, or you're in charge of restarting our plant at Chernobyl.
That was us?
That doesn't leave this room.
Well, brother, prepare to enjoy another day of calm, peaceful behavior on the school bus.
I gotta warn you, a lot of kids are pretty unhappy with the required seating.
Well, they'll be happy when I also organize cafeteria seating, who's picked for teams, and I've divided the playground into swingers and pushers.
That's insane!
You just bought yourself a year of pushing. Order, order, maintain order.
Tuttle!
This message couldn't be clearer. The children need more sauce on their spaghetti. Also, their spelling is atrocious.
Well, at least I have my photos.
I thought I had made things better.
Lisa, the bus is supposed to be crazy. It's the brief respite between the twin nightmares of home and school.
The one thing a know-it-all doesn't know is that everyone hates a know-it-all.
Did we lose anyone?
Just the police chief, son.
I bit a rat!
Marge, this is the last time I'm coming by.
Oh, that's fine. I mean, I do have my knitting to get to.
I'm going to a living hell followed by a certain death. Here's a picture to remember me by, taken by my grandma from her deathbed. The last thing she saw.
What's wrong, honey?
I don't feel like I have anyone to talk to.
I appreciate that, and I'd like to talk. I'm just so drained after all the time I spend with the kids.
What time?
I took you to that colonial village.
That was a pub at the airport.
I had an ale, you sat in a barrel, that makes it colonial.
Homer, I'm sorry, you have to understand. Without Waylon to talk to, I feel completely alone.
I totally get it. One question. Who's Waylon?
Smithers.
Totally get it. Oh, my wife really needs something, and to get it, I may have to forego my settlement.
Homer, you fell down a trapdoor into a cement mixer. Don't you think I deserve something for that?
I'm just trying to do what's right.
Then why did you file a lawsuit?
I really think you should change the venue, sir. You can't win a case in this town.
Oh, are they still mad about me eating the town panda? Get over it.
Wait! I'm willing to sign anything you want, on one condition.
Fine. What's your condition?
You have to keep Mr. Smithers here.
I see. And are you fool enough to believe a man's handshake means anything?
I am.
Well, put her there.
Homer, no! Why doesn't anyone ever think of the lawyer?
Oh, if I do a slip and fall on the courthouse steps, would that help?
It might.
See you Thursday, and I'll see you Thursday night.
Oh, and I'll see you early Friday morning. Oh, these slippery stairs! Whoa!
Oh, homie!
Marge, no! Marge, I know Smithers was good at talking to you, and I want to talk to you, too. Just don't expect me to be great at first.
Oh, honey, no one's great their first time. It's like baking.
Oh, okay. Well, I like you.
And I adore you. You sacrificed yourself for my happiness. There is nothing that makes a woman feel more cherished and secure. Thank you, my darling.
Marge, this is going great.
Now, don't you worry. I made you both soup. Oh, it's piping hot. 2 hours in the microwave. Yeah!
From the hills of the Tamar Valley, taste the difference of pure, all-natural goodness. Deliciously thick and creamy yogurt.
Real fruit with a serving of cream from Tamar Valley Dairy. The creamery, the better.
Who knows what the DC stands for in Washington, D.C.? Anyone? Anyone?
Mustn't be a know-it-all. Never again. Not worth it.
D.C. Anyone?
Daddy's Kitchen?
Ugh.
Not quite. Anyone else? No? Okay. Children, D.C. stands for District of the Capital.
No, it doesn't! The answer is District of Columbia! And Miss Hoover, I don't want to be a smarty pants, but the previous answer was Texas. Before that, 1848. Before that, Seward's Folly. And your dentist appointment is not tomorrow, it's the day after. Thank you.
Hardest test in the world. Who'd want to do that?
Oh, hey, Bart. What you doing?
They say this one single test can tell if you're a genius or not.
Looks pretty simple to me.
It says only one out of every 400 people has the spatial reasoning to solve this maze. Elon Musk and Angela Merkel both got perfect scores.
Angela.
Now, if you're so smart, let's see you solve the maze.
Let me at it. Okay, got through the first one. Next one's a little harder. Just gonna focus.
You passed the test, genius. Epic sister fail.
You better not post that.
And post.
Oh, you scared me and denied me a genius test.
Well, when you got an opportunity to prank, you gotta take it. Gotta take it. And the likes are pouring in. Whoa, Sideshow Mel retweeted it to all his boneheads.
Are you almost done?
You have your office. This is mine.
I don't know how, I don't know when, but I super know why. I'll get revenge on you, Bart Simpson.
Will you be wearing my underpants when that happens?
Yeah.
And post. 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 Post.
Unpost! Unpost!
And post.
The internet is down!
I don't know the score. I don't even remember who's playing.
Okay, no internet. We can do what we did in the olden days. When I was a child...
You better not be suggesting a board game.
I'm not playing anything with you ever again.
Okay, fine. No board games.
Dumb. Useless. Piece missing. So flammable. Okay, look. The TV still works, and I know we've seen all our DVDs 100 times, so this could be the perfect time to break out Daddy's VHS collection. Classic moments from a time when people used to tape the shows they loved, then never watch the tape again.
Family Matters?
It certainly does.
The Tracy Ullman Show?
Well, I've had my fill.
Saved by the Bell?
The hit show that launched no one's career. Now for the simple task of hooking up the VCR. Okay, I need to connect magenta to magenta, set the tracking. Marge, did I record these in long play or extended play?
What's the difference?
Long is shorter.
Gross! The remote has a cord on it.
My first remote. Coincidentally, the same time I got fat.
What is that noise?
It's rewinding. Listen to it speed up as it gets closer.
Ooh. Well, that was fun. Good night.
No, now we play it.
Ricola!
I used to love that commercial.
Remember when I went as the horn for Halloween?
Ricola!
Boo!
No worries, we just have to find a VCR repair store. I'll look online, which I can't because there's no internet. Damn it! Lisa, solve this.
I've solved enough puzzles today.
Well, Flanner's network is working. Maybe we could ask him for the password.
You can't just ask someone for their password. That's rude. Come on, boy, let's go borrow his router.
How come all our father-son activities involve getting a TV back on?
What about the time I watched you get out of that thing?
You mean when I was born?
That was fun.
If I die before I wake, I pray the Lord my soul to take. Amen.
That's right, boys. Think about your possible deaths as you go to sleep.
Now let's look at my plans. Who's this ladder made for, babies?
Oh!
You'll have to climb it, boy.
I'm a little scared.
Scared? What do we give you those meds for?
So you can do less parenting?
Babysitter in a bottle. Now climb the ladder.
So beautiful.
Almost there. You just need to go up the last rung.
That's not a rung. It's the top.
The top is a rung?
No, it's not.
Let me check on Google.
We don't have internet.
Well, maybe if I keep refreshing, it'll come back. Refresh, 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 refresh. Oh, this is pointless. Refresh, refresh, refresh.
Ooh!
No. Refresh, refresh. Refresh.
You guys need jackets?
No, we're fine. Nope.
The internet's back on. Doctor, is he gonna be all right?
Millions of volts coursed through his body, but it was the amps that really messed with him. But he should be fine. According to his chart, Bart's had more comas than he's had hot breakfasts.
Well, I can't cook every morning.
Until he recovers, just talk to him. Lightning victims are highly suggestible. Your kind words could turn his coma into a trip to Hawaii or a golf excursion to St. Andrews, which is where I'm heading now.
Yep, when you got an opportunity to prank, you gotta take it. Gotta take it.
But you're in a coma.
Fine, I'll get revenge.
You're gonna see dragons with pools of blood. Oh, right, you like that. Okay, scratch the dragons. You're gonna see the one thing everyone's afraid of, death and dead people.
That's right, buddy.
Okay, Bart, your nightmare begins.
Oh, what happened? How long was I out? Maud Flanders, I thought you were dead.
I am.
Sweetie, we're gonna get something to eat. You wanna come?
I'd rather stay with Bart. In fact, I'd like to stay with him all night.
Such a sweet girl.
So sweet.
Aw, someone's not happy. You know, that sign should be unnecessary. I'd better cheer him up.
Ah! I am going to add to your dream the worst thing I can imagine.
Let me see.
What's up?
Milhouse.
What's going on, Bart? Are you into God now? I always was.
Look at those abs. The secret is less loaves, more fishes.
I don't believe in some dopey religion. This is to keep out ghosts.
Oh, this looks just like my first apartment with Ned. I'm never leaving.
Milhouse, have you ever been haunted?
Once my hamster died and then came back. Actually, my parents bought a new one and thought I wouldn't know. Then my dad's check bounced and they repoed the hamster.
You've got to talk to me, Bart.
Leave me alone. Leave me alone! The power of Homer Socks compels you! Maybe you could use this. My therapist. If you see him, can you give him this? Don't tell him I forgot to bring it back. He'll say I kept it to get attention. I don't need attention, Dr. Sam!
I knew it was Milhouse. I knew it! What's on your mind, son?
I'm scared to say. You'll toss me in the loony bin.
Bart, these days there are no more loony bins. All those people are on the streets. So how can I help you?
I've been talking to a ghost. I know, you think I'm the nuttiest kid you've seen.
Oh, please, I can't tell you what a relief it is to not be talking to Milhouse.
Are you allowed to say stuff like that?
No, but screw it. My mom found my dad's other cell phone, boo-hoo!
So you don't think I'm crazy?
No, take a look behind the couch.
You're dead too?
Yeah, I killed myself 5 minutes before you got here.
Why would you kill yourself?
Oh, I want my patients to think it's all their fault. Oh, if you'd been on time, you might have saved my life. But, you know, whatever.
Why is this happening to me?
I don't know, but you have a gift. You can see the dead, Bart.
Why am I waiting for a bus? I can appear and disappear whenever I want. And it's late. That's far enough.
And Bart, you can help us ghosts move on to what comes next.
By telling your family you love them?
Which family? I've led a complicated life. No, to move on, I need you to get revenge on Dr. Morton, with whom I share the office.
What have you got against him?
He won't shut up about his Tesla.
Yes, yes, just as smart as I always thought I...
Thank you, Bart. Now I can move on. Uh-oh.
Wow, helping him felt really good.
Help us, Bart. Help us.
Settle our beefs.
Beefs.
Please help me get vengeance against all jet engines, and then I will go to hell.
Didn't anybody finish their business before dying?
All I want to do is return this hatchet.
Fine.
Okay, I want you to whack Johnny Tight Lips, Ice Fat Tony, and put a hit on Joey Doublecross. Who would have figured he'd rat me out?
No!
Zimalate?
Loving you is easy. Loving you is never pain in the guts.
Fresh, natural Zimmel. The easy-to-digest milk.
Yeah. Next.
You can't keep ignoring me.
Doctor, shouldn't he have woken up by now?
Yes. He should, unless someone's been telling him bad things.
What do you mean?
Anything negative someone says could do permanent damage to his brain function. It could even kill him.
But you said he'd be fine.
I said he'd be fine if you told him he was at a dolphin encounter on Maui.
But those dolphins aren't fine. They try to kill themselves.
I said he'd be fine, not the dolphins.
Oh, no. Oh, Bart, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. I'll watch everything I say.
Oh, I had to walk 9 blocks to get this. I am dead.
Dad, no.
9 blocks. I am dead. Dead.
Finally, you get to me.
Yeah. What's your unfinished business?
Revenge against the man who caused my death.
Hey, T-shirt.
Fire!
Ooh, a bobby pin.
Oh!
You mean the guy who invented the t-shirt guns?
No.
The guys who built the stadium with a really low back wall?
No.
You? For standing up?
No, your father, your stupid, stupid father.
You know, some people grow when they die. Not you.
See you guys. That was fun getting every answer in Jeopardy wrong. All that saying goodbye really made me thirsty.
Maude Flanders says hello.
Hello.
Let's move.
Oh, thank you, Bart. I'm finally at peace.
You know Ned remarried.
He what?
Well, that's it. All the ghosts have been helped.
Except one.
Dad, you weren't supposed to die. It was just supposed to scare you.
Oh, don't worry. Patricide is just a part of life. Ooh, your vocabulary really goes up when you die.
Dad, I am so sorry I killed you.
It's cool. I feel no pain.
Go! I was wrong. It feels worse than in life. Get away, you stupid cat! Go!
Oh, I can't believe you're dead. But at least I can still see you while I help you with your unfinished business.
Well, I wanted to lose some weight, but I'm light as a feather now. All that's left is for me to go into the light.
You know how much you hate walking? Stay with me.
Stay with me, Bart. Stay with me.
Oh, homie. It's not your fault. You were doomed when they started putting cheese into pizza crust. What's next? Plugging Swiss cheese with cookie dough? Peanut butter and hot dogs?
Why isn't anyone writing these things down? I can't watch this. I'm gonna go check in on Moe's.
I don't know what's wrong. I served them lager. Uh-oh.
I should go, son. I leave this world without a care, knowing I raised two great kids, plus the one who murdered me.
No, Bart, you have to stay with me.
No, Dad, you have to stay with me.
No, my time has come. Man was not meant to live beyond the age of 39.
You have to stay. If you leave, Mom will marry someone else.
I want her to be happy.
And someone else will raise your kids.
Sucker.
And someone else will ride your mower.
That bastard!
But still, it's time for me to move on. Oh, my God. It's so beautiful.
Dad!
Why, you little... life-saving heaven can waiting!
Bart, I'm so sorry if I was ever mean to you. Because even though you started it, you...
Sorry. Sorry. I'm past that.
I love you. And I want you back, Bart Simpson.
Lisa.
Oh, he's awake! Thank God!
Lisa, have you been by my side this whole time?
I have.
Were you putting those bad dreams in my head?
Yes.
Can you teach me how to do it?
I guess.
And can you help me put Dad in a coma?
No.
Oh, man, this is great. But how do I know this isn't a dream, too?
Because you're not wearing the sweater.
Oh, yeah, of course. Wait a minute. How did he know about the sweater?
Bart, did you see anything else when you were under?
Just how we're all gonna die. Want me to tell you?
Not really.
Well, I'm gonna tell you anyway.
Ouch. I have lost myself again. Lost myself.
I knew it was a sandwich.
Yeah. I feel
been a waste of time. Are we there yet?
No.
Are we there yet?
No.
Are we there yet?
I said no!
Are we there?